What's up, everyone? I'm Danielle Carrington.
I'm Nikki Sunshine.
And welcome to another edition of
Let's Get Greedy.
Ow. We're doing another how-to video.
How-to videos are on pop. You guys really enjoy learning about the recipes that Let's Get Greedy and the mastermind, the DJ Khaled of it all.
DJ, I got the keys. I got the cheese, really.
Right. You guys really enjoy the things that we come up with. So let's keep giving it to them. What are we doing today?
Well, last time, remember, you was very disappointed in me that I came up with some ideas called the Soul Food Burrito and the Soul Food Alfredo. And you was mad as hell.
Yeah.
So I was like, you know what? I got something.
Because you snuck behind my back.
I did.
And cooked again. Danielle.
I'm sorry. My bad. My bad, bro. I said, okay, I got you. Let's do a soul food risotto. You know what risotto is, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Basically, risotto is like an Italian rice, but it's cooked in broth. It depends on what type of risotto you're making.
I like the way you say that. Broth.
Cooked in broth.
Oh, yeah.
Makes it really nice and creamy.
Give them that sexy mouth.
Put some cheese on it. It just really make it come together and it brings this joy.
Merge.
You are hot, man. Today we're making a soul food risotto.
Risotto.
And if you want to check out our soul food Alfredo and soul food burrito, just click the link in the description box and you can check it out. Really good recipes.
I must say, I'm already really excited about the dish because I can smell the ingredients.
Ooh, yeah, right?
Oh my gosh. I can smell the smoked meat,
smell that cheese.
The cheese, the green. Ugh, this is going to be fabulous.
It's going to be yummy. So what we're going to do is we're going to put your pot on low medium heat. All right? And you're going to use 2 tablespoons of butter.
Start it off right.
You want to do it right now with some butter. Paula Deen would be so proud of us.
Why is it that Paula Deen now is synonymous with butter? Because every time you said butter, I thought of Paula Deen.
Yeah, I think because she's the butter lady.
She's the butter queen.
She ought to come out with her own butter. She would make billions if she came out with her own butter.
No, she wouldn't.
I mean, not right at this moment.
Not give now. A couple years. Not after she started lynching black people.
She won't lynching too many people. But
well, she was. She had a couple houses.
You know what's funny?
Negroes
running. You know what's funny?
Huh?
People can be mad at Paula Deen all they want, but I bet you still Googling her recipes. Shade?
People. No, ain't no shade. I love Paula Deen.
I still Google her recipes.
I won't trash talk Paula
Deen. That girl can cook.
I'm just speaking hashtag Paula Deen buttery facts.
That girl can cook.
Yeah, she can cook.
All right, so we have a medium onion.
Red onion.
It doesn't matter. It could be either or. It could be red, white. It doesn't matter as long as it's a medium
onion. I want black onion.
I want
a Black Lives Matter onion.
Well, I don't think they make
power to the people.
I don't think they make Black Lives Matter onions unless somebody was lynched making this onion, so in the fields. So I'm gonna throw that in the pot. Now this is what the gotcha is.
The gotcha?
Yeah, this is the creme de la creme of what we need to talk about.
Mm-hmm.
This is the holy grail right here.
Ooh.
On your matter. Yeah, saffron.
Yes.
You know what saffron is?
Yes.
What's saffron?
It's a very expensive herb that they use in paella. And it's super expensive in Spain. I don't know if it originated in Spain, but it's red and it's super expensive. I don't really know what the flavor is, though.
Well, saffron is, it comes from a flower called the saffron crocus.
Oh.
And they use the thread.
You've been reading behind my back again.
I can read. I don't just do coloring books, Nikki. I just don't do coloring books, okay?
All right.
And what's crazy about this, it looks like this. Let me tell you. You've seen it before.
It looks like thread, right?
It looks like thread. Look at that.
Ooh.
Smell it.
Ooh.
It has a distinct smell.
It has a very interesting.
Yeah.
Sweet almost smell.
It's a very unique smell, but it's threads of that. And guess how much this, just a pinch. You see this? A pinch of this cost $18.
What you talking about, Willis?
$18 because it's grown in certain parts of the world.
Mm-hmm.
It's to the point, like, I wish I could order some of the seeds and grow it myself and sell this in front of Whole
Foods. Hey, yo, I got that saffron.
25, 20, 20. Hey, yo. Look, be careful. That's some expensive. Don't let that stuff leak out.
I'm
about to sweep it off the floor. That stuff is expensive.
I'm
throwing the crap on you on a Sunday, girl. What's wrong with you? Yeah, but That's some expensive herbs here. So we're gonna use a pinch of this and put it in there while it's melting.
Yeah. Let me help you stir it up a bit.
I only need a pinch of it. Mm-hmm. Because it'll, so it can dissolve. Yep, that's all you need, like a little pinch.
What is that gonna do?
Just gives it aroma to the risotto. Gives it a nice aroma.
You paying $18 to give something an aroma? See, you've been hanging out with fancy folks a little too much for me.
Oh, educated people? Yeah, no, that's fancy. What I've been doing.
Mm-hmm. I'm sure it must give it some type of flavor. It's got to be more than an aroma, no?
It gives it a nice aroma. You'll see that once you taste the risotto, you're like, oh, that's that. You can tell the saffron. Now we're going to put the Italian rice. You can use any long grain rice, but I'm bad and bougie. I'm bad and bougie. This is Italian rice, huh? Mm-hmm.
So we'll pour. The difference is it looks shorter than your regular long grain rice. It's a shorter rice and it looks a little flatter.
Yeah, I'll show you a picture of it. Yeah. You put it in there. So we're gonna put it in there and let it coat it. So make sure when you stir it.
Make sure you do a body roll when you stir it. Put a body roll into it.
Let me see that body roll. That body roll. We use a cup and a half. All right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, so get it all in there.
Yeah. The butter looks like it's coated right well, and that's what we want.
Mm-hmm. Excited, ain't you? You never made nothing like this. You made this for your man, girl.
I'm super excited.
Now, we're going to use half a cup of dry white wine.
Ooh, child!
Bougie, bad
and bougie with your white wine and your rice.
Bad and bougie. Cooking the rice with
it. Now, can church people use that as well? Is that okay?
Yeah, I mean, if y'all use a wine to bless with the bread in church, then.
No, don't put grape wine. Don't think you're going to put your communion wine into this risotto. That's not, not going to work.
Now, we're going to make sure everything cooks down until the alcohol boils now.
Okay.
And once we do that, we can start putting. This is the most tedious part.
Okay.
Is the broth.
Okay.
And the reason why the broth is very tedious is because you gotta put like half a cup of broth, 6 cups worth, in there until it cooks down.
6 cups worth?
Yeah. It has to constantly.
That's a lot of broth.
It is, but you're not putting 6 cups in right now. You're putting half a cup of it in one at a time, let it boil down, and then constantly put it in, stir until it cooks it and gets it nice and fluffy.
Ain't nobody got time.
I got time, girl. If you want some good, 5-star.
Woo! That's a long time.
Look, we got saffron on the table. Saffron down. You know how expensive this is? Put it in there.
Did you just pick up crumbs off the table and
saffron
pour it in our risotto?
So the alcohol is boiled down. And we just keep on cooking. We can't do
should one. We give them a closer look at what it looks like? Just like this?
We could. Smell good, don't it? Mm-hmm. Alright. So it's gonna boil down just a little bit more just so we can pour it in there.
I feel like the heat is up too high.
Mm-mm, it's fine. I got you.
Alright. Don't burn this rice.
I'm gonna
be highly upset.
Honey, I'm a fake ass chef. Hashtag fake ass chef. It's just about broth right now. It's all about broth until we get the rice good. Matter of fact, let me get 2 spoons because towards the end we gotta make sure that the rice is cooked properly because we don't want like
2 spoons under. For what? You can't spare the same spoon with me?
Well, you was over there coughing up the lung 2 seconds ago.
Listen, I'm not coughing now. I've cleared it up.
What was that 2 seconds ago? I caught it cloudy now. I love you. You know, when black women angry. Mm-hmm.
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 Yeah. It's looking good.
See, it's starting to like start getting kind of fluffed up a
little
bit. But it's just that's the only tedious part is just stirring, putting in the broth.
You know, on Bleecker Street, they had a whole restaurant dedicated to risotto.
No, really?
Yeah.
Right, and put me on. I love
it. It's closed now. I guess it wasn't as popular.
People don't appreciate the risotto life. I love risotto.
So it's looking like it's thickening up.
Mm-hmm. Still got some ways to go, girl. I can tell that that stuff is not ready yet.
It looks buttery, though, because it's like yellow. Yeah. A lot of butter in there.
That's not all the butter we're putting
saffron.
In there.
Saffron. The saffron probably turned it a little yellow, yeah. too, right?
And also, that's not the only butter we're putting in there. We got more butter.
Ooh,
to put in
more
there.
Butter to put
more
in?
More butter, more ingredients. Yeah. To make it more sexier.
Baby.
And creamier. As you guys can see, our rice has thickened up with all the broth we use. We use a good 6 cups of broth, but we put a little at a time. So it's supposed to be this consistency. Now we're gonna add the other ingredients.
I must say, this risotto is a little labor intensive because I've been stirring it for the past 10 minutes straight.
And I don't know if it's been
10 minutes. Every time you add the broth, you have to add it a little bit at a time and keep mm-hmm. stirring, keep stirring. Or your risotto might not come out the way you want it to.
All right. I'm going to put some salt and pepper for taste.
Not too much salt because remember there's cheese that's going to go into this.
Yes. And also smoked turkey.
Smoked turkey. So there's salt on that.
So a pinch of salt, a pinch of pepper. And we're going to put 4 tablespoons of butter.
And there's salt in that too.
Yeah, so you can use unsalted butter if you like. You just cut down on the.
I don't like unsalted butter.
Well, you use unsalted butter when you cook pastries.
Okay.
Yeah, but that's what a lot of people use unsalted butter for.
Okay.
But when you're making your eggs and all that stuff, you can use salted butter if you like. So we're gonna let that butter stir down.
Ooh, this butter is stirring in.
Isn't it pretty? Oh, it's so
beautiful. This is gonna be really creamy.
Nice and creamy. Mm-hmm.
Do you like potatoes au gratin? Au gratin potatoes?
I love them. Have you ever had homemade potatoes? Oh God, this is gonna change your life. I know how to make homemade potatoes au gratin.
Oh really?
Mm-hmm.
What's not to like about potatoes, cream, and cheese?
And butter.
Well, I guess your waistline might not like it.
Also now, what we're gonna do is start doing this. Yeah, let me stir.
What goes in next?
Let's do the collard greens. This is unsalted collard greens, low sodium. Because this is already going to have salt in it, so you don't want to make it too overpowering with all that. So I'm going to stir that in there.
Get your collards. Get your good collards. Now tell me, did you get this out of a can?
I did.
Mm-hmm.
Hand me my stewed tomatoes. Now those collards was like... about a cup.
That was a cup of collards?
Mm-hmm.
It looked like a half a cup.
Mm-hmm, about a cup. Mm-hmm. And we're using stewed tomatoes, unsalted.
Ooh. Unsalted. Now this is starting to look like a real meal.
Mm-hmm.
This looks hearty. This actually might be a good dish for a dinner party.
Yeah.
Or like if you're trying to serve a big amount of people.
Mm-hmm. Now, hand me the turkey. It's a smoked turkey leg, chopped up. Now this is like already like salty, so you just wanna make sure. That's why we didn't wanna use too much salt.
Now you gotta put a little bit of elbow grease into this, you know, like Big Mama used to do. Get on in there, stir it up, like you really know how. And make sure it's all incorporated in.
Fold that in there nice and
perfect. Oh yeah, this is looking great.
Now, we're gonna cut this heat down all the way on low a little bit because it's basically finished cooking.
Ooh, this thing is thick and creamy.
Oh, it's gonna be real creamy. Hand me that cheese.
Oh yeah, the party just got crunk.
I'm gonna use a half a cup of freshly grated Parmesan cheese.
That white girl just got in. Oh, that looks, that for me. Now you're sending me over the moon with
this
cheese.
To the moon.
When you put this Parmesan cheese in here, that's when you have my attention.
Got your attention now.
Oh, man. Oh, my goodness.
Get it all in there. Make sure it melts. And once it melts, we're ready to go.
We're ready to eat?
You're ready to eat. You want to plate it?
Oh, girl.
And we're going to eat.
Wow.
Let it melt all. Yep.
Ooh, I can smell the collard greens. And I can smell the smoked turkey. This one right here is a winner.
I know it is. I know. Well, you need to taste it. Give me a high five when you taste it.
And it looks beautiful.
So now we're going to plate it, and I'm going to put some freshly grated parsley flakes on top. I'm all about that plating.
Wow.
I know. Something serious.
Impressive. I wonder if you could eat this for brunch.
Yeah, you could eat. I mean,
you could eat risotto for brunch. They serve risotto for brunch.
Why not?
With maybe a little mimosa.
I'm gonna move this to the side so I can.
Risotto, soul food risotto with the Welch's grape mimosa. With a grape soda mimosa.
And with Biggie Smalls playing in the background.
That's a ghetto urban brunch experience.
He's so cute. Mm. Okay, got some fresh parsley leaves. That's too big. I don't like it now. So my pictures.
Oh, that's beautiful.
And I gotta get some fresh Parmesan cheese on top.
Oh, you put more cheese?
Oh, girl, bye.
More cheese, please.
More cheese.
More cheese. I love cheese. You know what? I would like to open up a little shop, and it would just be cheese and chocolate, because those are my two big vices. Those are my two guilty pleasures, cheese and chocolate. Anybody with me? Anybody riding with me on that? You riding with me on that, Danielle?
Yeah, I'm riding with you, girl.
Okay.
I ride or die with you, honey. Looks good, don't it?
Recap what's in this.
Basically, we put butter.
Butter.
Saffron.
Saffron.
Italian rice.
Mm-hmm.
Chicken stock.
Mm-hmm.
Fresh parsley on top.
Mm-hmm.
Then for the creme of the creme, we have smoked turkey. We have collard greens and stewed tomatoes and more Parmesan on top.
I think I'm ready.
Toast. Ow, it was like a sword.
Sorry.
She took my finger off.
I got aggressive.
She got aggressive.
To let you know, stay off my side.
Let's go for it. I don't know. You smell the collard greens, you do. This is so good.
Josephine, you put your foot in this.
My name's Danielle, girl.
Woo!
What do you taste first?
Okay. First of all, the consistency of the risotto is beautiful.
Mm.
It just feels so nice and creamy in my mouth. Don't.
Hashtag. No
hashtag.
Homo.
Stop it. So right there, just a good, I taste the collard greens. It tastes smoky because of that smoked meat.
Yes.
The stewed tomatoes is a perfect because it's kind of like a little bit of a acidic.
Yeah.
Little acid to it.
Yeah.
I think this is a winner. This is a winner.
Mm.
This is so good.
You happy? She always complains I never invite her over for a good Sunday dinner. Bam. Soul food risotto.
Let me get some on your side and see if your side tastes as good
as
mine.
It's all the same, boo. It's all the same. Sorry, we get over here. We're supposed to be signing out. You know we love something when we keep on digging in it. And can't stop.
I'm not ready to sign out yet.
Oh, well, talk to him. Talk to him a little bit more. Talk to him.
Doggone. You know what? The tomatoes give it more of like a pasta feel.
Yeah.
Because when you taste it, you're like, oh, it tastes a little bit like pasta sauce. I must say, if you like risotto, this recipe right here,
I'm gonna change your life.
I can't say anything bad about it. And you know what? It doesn't taste too salty.
Yeah. It's so good.
It tastes perfect.
I feel like I'm in a restaurant somewhere in Harlem.
It tastes perfect.
Yeah.
And you can do some modifications with this, I guess.
You can make, like I said, you can make any type of risotto you like. It's up to you. It's whatever
you
like.
You can put some shrimps in it.
Shrimp. You can make fried chicken in there, like I did the fried chicken and the soul food Alfredo. But me, I didn't want to overburden it because it already had the smoked turkey and risotto is supposed to be like very, has a simplicity to it. So I didn't want to put too much protein
in it. But you know what? I like exactly the ingredients that you use, yeah, because each ingredient is flavorful in and of itself. Mm-hmm. If you use any type of seafood, keep in mind that the risotto is going to draw its flavor from whatever your protein, how you flavor your protein. So I would recommend if you're going to put shrimp or something in it or lobster, make sure you like put garlic in it or season it well.
Well, and the thing is too, use a seafood broth when you're doing a seafood risotto.
Good point.
You
know,
if you're vegetarian, use a vegetable broth. It's up to you. It's whatever, how you like it. But at the end of the day, this is what we're doing today. We did a chicken stock, and it came out so good.
Oh my gosh, yeah. Danielle. Kudos to you. I take my hat off. This dish is absolutely fantastic, and I would pay for this. This probably would be like a $27 dish.
All right, got your money? I'm broke.
What?
I need some money.
I need some money. You get the tax money. $27, I share with you.
You ain't got no tax money.
I give you $3, I didn't eat that much.
You ain't got no tax money? Your tax money didn't come back in?
You don't pay no taxes.
You don't pay no taxes? You don't snitch on yourself, world. The government's always watching.
Where's Wesley Snipes? They're tapping my phone.
But thank you guys for riding out with us for another how-to video for Let's Get Greedy. Make sure you like, subscribe, tell your family and friends. We're just trying to show you some things. We just want to say we love you. I'm Danielle Carrington.
I'm Nikki Sunshine.
And we out.
Bye.
Deuces. Girl.
This shit was fire. Oh, sorry. I wasn't supposed to say that.
Well, you can say whatever you want.
Yo, this right here is perfection.
Greedy girl for real. Don't